Hello everyone, how are you doing? I hope you all are doing well. I am Anisha, your maths teacher, is here again with a new topic. In the last video, we learned about multiplication, and today we are going to learn something related to division. And we will see how these two operations, multiplication and division, are related to each other. But before we start, please like my video and subscribe my YouTube channel and also press the bell icon so that you will get notified whenever I upload new videos for you. Let's get going. So dear children, our topic is division. And what does it mean? It means splitting into equal parts or groups. Splitting means to divide something into equal parts or groups. And we all use this operation in our daily life, and you also use it, but we don't realize it. Like, we used to share something into equal parts among siblings, like cookies, like something else. We used to divide that thing into equal parts so that everybody gets equal sharing, and the symbol of division is this. And we also say that the process of repeated subtraction is called division. Yes, like in multiplication we used to say repeated addition, but in division we say repeated subtraction. Now we are going to do divide by using repeated subtraction. Now kids, here you can see that I have taken one example, and in this we are going to divide this number using repeated subtraction. Now we will simply write this number 12 and we will subtract 3 from it and we will get 9. Then 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Then 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. By this you can see we have subtracted this 3 4 times. First time, second time, third time and fourth time. And this is our answer. Dear kids, you must know the terms that we use in division. Now, here we are going to learn the terms that we use in division. I have taken one example for you, like 12. Here, the number that divides 12 is 3, and the quotient that we get here is 4, and what is left out here? That is 0. Now, what is dividend? The number to be divided is called the dividend, and it is denoted by capital D then small d. And what is quotient here? Quotient is denoted by capital Q. The answer that we get on dividing the numbers is called quotient. What is divisor? Divisor is denoted by capital D and small r. The number that divides is called divisor. What is remainder? Remainder is denoted by capital R, and the number that remains after dividing is called remainder. Now, we need to note here that remainder is always smaller than divisor. Like in this you can see 0. 0 is smaller than 3. So, remainder is always smaller than divisor. Now, we are going to do Mental Maths 19, that is given on page number 21. So, are you all ready? Let's do it. 48 is divided by 8. Now, how can we do it? We know table of 8. Everybody has learned table of 8, right? So, 48. Now, we need to find out on which number does 48 come in table of 8? That is 6. So here Our answer is 6. And 6 is the quotient here. Now next is 100 divided by 10. Now again, everybody has learned table of 10, right? So can you answer me? Very good. So here answer is 10. Now next one is 54 is divided by 6. Very good. Here answer is 9. My dear children, if you want to do these type of questions quickly, you need to learn the tables. And those who have already done that, they must have found doing these questions is just a piece of cake, isn't it? Now, let's have a look at relation between multiplication and division.
Multiplication and division are very closely related. Let us see how. Look, there are 5 kids. Each kid has 9 balloons. How many balloons are there in all with the 5 kids? So, here we multiply the numbers 5 and 9 to get the answer. So, 5 into 9 is equal to 45. If we look at the same example in a different way, there are 45 balloons. If each kid has 9 balloons, then find the number of kids such that the balloons are distributed equally. Here, we need to divide 45 by 9 to find the quotient. We get 45 divided by 9 is equal to 5. Now, if there are 5 kids and 45 balloons in all, how many balloons does each kid get? Here, we divide 45 by 5 to find the quotient. 45 divided by 5 is equal to 9. Look, here we got both multiplication and division facts from the same example.
Now, as you have learned, there is a relation between multiplication and division, right? This is the sign of multiplication and this is the sign of division. They both are friends and they both are closely related. Now here we are going to learn how to write multiplication fact and division fact. See, it's so easy. Now 42 divided by 7 equals to 6. Multiplication fact. So first fact means the first way to write the multiplication fact is like we will write 6 multiplied by 7 equals to 42. And the second way to write the multiplication fact, we just change the positions. By this also, we'll get 42. Alright. Now, here we will write the division fact for this multiplication fact. How we will write it? See, we just write the dividend, means the biggest number first. 85 is divided by 5 is equal to 17. And again, we will write the biggest number, that is 85, and 85 is divided by 17 is equal to 5. All right. So, my dear kids, I believe that you must have learned how to write multiplication fact and how to write division fact. Now, let's see what you have to do in your homework. You have to do Mental Maths 19, that is given on page number 21 in book. And second thing, do homework 11 and 12 that are given on page numbers 53 and 54 in book only. And please do revise tables from 2 to 20. Alright. Thank you for watching. I hope you have understood this topic well. Now it's your attendance time. Please mark your attendance. Mention your name, class and section in the comment box. That's all for today. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.